Coming up on the Better Buildings Challenge Swap.
So this is interesting. If you look, we're 67 and a half degrees here. Back over by the machinery over there, we were 76, 77.
Noticing they've reduced the number of tubes per fixture.
That's a good practice we can take back to our facilities.
Yeah, definitely.
L'Oreal. General Motors. Hosted by Maria Vargas from the U.S. Department of Energy. Two energy teams swapped.
Well, welcome, everybody. It's so great to be here in Little Rock. I know I'm really excited today. How are you guys feeling?
We're excited, too. We're a little nervous, but we're sure we'll find some opportunities for L'Oreal and also find some great things that we can take back and share with our sites.
We're very excited about the fact that we have a car company, General Motors, and a beauty company, L'Oreal. These are big manufacturers using energy, often in very intensive ways. So the opportunity to learn and learn from somebody that may be very different from you is really high.
So it's trying to find the similarities between what we do in L'Oreal. And, you know, we paint vehicles, they kind of paint people. So the swap at L'Oreal is really exciting for us. We perform energy treasure hunts at our own facilities, but this will be a first.
Well, L'Oreal, thank you so much for having us here. We're excited to be in your house, Eric.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. We are fired up and really happy to welcome the GM team. We're really proud of our plant, so we want to show it off to you and see what opportunities you guys can find for us.
All right, well, let's not waste any time. Let's get going.
Okay, let's go. Let's suit up.
All right.
All right.
We're committed to reduce our environmental footprint, and the energy is part of that. We have five facilities in North America where we have very clear commitments for 2020. Reduce our CO2 emissions by 60%, reduce our water consumption by 60%, and our transportable waste by 60%. We're working very hard on that, and the results are great.
This is the original Maybelline factory that was built in 1975. It's an 830,000 square foot factory on a 100 acre campus. It's the largest cosmetics factory in the world for L'Oreal. We run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and we produce over 1 million units per day.
So this is our liquids packaging area. Here we make things like lip gloss, concealer, and makeup remover. Right now on this line is this color. Do you guys make a car this color?
Oh, sure, yeah. That'd sell very well.
Yeah, I think it's your shade, Al.
All right.
Brian and Al obviously don't know much about makeup, but I do a little bit, so it was very fun for me to see how all of them were made.
Let's check out how warm it is in there. Wow, looks like it's almost 300 degrees.
And look at all that heat they're losing out of the top portion there.
Yeah, I wonder if they can lower that.
Yeah, that's a question we'll have to ask them. So this is interesting. If you look, we're 67 and a half degrees here. Back over by the machinery over there, we were 76, 77, so there's been a considerable drop.
Yeah, there has. It feels a lot cooler
yeah,
over
it does.
Here.
And this is kind of an open area, no machinery. They're putting out about 55 degrees out the air handling unit. I wonder if they're in economizer mode. We should ask that, find out.
So welcome to our nail polish packaging area, everyone. This is where we run Essie nail polish, so an iconic brand.
I'm very excited for this part. Hopefully we can find some good energy opportunities
as well. I'm sure you can.
Noticing they've reduced the number of tubes per fixture.
That's a good practice we can take back to our facilities.
Yeah, definitely.
Their LED retrofit provided them more light. That's good. So it looks like there's a purge cabinet there. We should ask them what's the difference between those and other ones that aren't purged.
Yeah, and again, can this be turned off when they're not running? And how much are they not running?
Yep, good point.
I seem to be making a lot of nail polish.
Right.
Compressed air is how they move everything here. So if they can turn it off when they don't need it, that would be huge energy savings. Compressed air is one of the most expensive utilities. So if any time you can turn it off is really helpful.
I'm definitely hearing an air leak here, but I think the bigger one's on the other side. Guys, I think it's up there.
I can definitely hear it up there. I'm also hearing a lot of HVAC. I can see some ducts there. There's nothing really going on here, though. It's an opportunity to shut down some of the air in this area.
And then if you look there, there's an open duct there. Four of them down the row. So that's probably an opportunity to close those off. If you put a VFD on the dust collector, then you could lower the airflow.
So welcome to our Mascara production area. It's the biggest part of our operation in North Little Rock, and we run 24/7 here. Miss Judy's gonna take us and show us all around. She's our line operator for line 11. So show us what you made.
Sure, y'all, come on, come this way.
Good, so you seem really engaged in this
whole
process.
I love my job.
What about the energy aspects of it?
When the line is down, we shut the conveyor belts and the lines off.
Wow, great.
So we don't have wasting any energy or anything like that.
Excellent. That's really good.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
And energy, you do that in your
home
here?
Yes, I turn all my lights off when I'm not in the room,
excellent.
And the TV and all the water and all that.
So
if I got a water leak, I fix all of that stuff.
Cool. So you brought that culture home with you?
Yes, sir, I did.
All right. That's excellent to hear.
Great to hear. Yeah.
Our global sustainability program is called Sharing Beauty with All, but we really want to personalize it for each plant and location. And so, of course, in Arkansas, it's Sharing Beauty with Y'all.
That's awesome. So I really like the way that energy saved by recycling one aluminum can is enough to power a laptop. That really links it into a person 5.2 hours.
For sure. We're really trying to make these things seem tangible to the people who work here every day to make everyone feel like they own a piece of renewable energy.
Also noticing some employees on your wall here, so definitely done a good job of making it personal.
Sharing Beauty with All is our global sustainability strategy, and it aims to address our environmental footprint at every stage of business.
And that employee engagement piece of it is something that I'm definitely taking back. They're really making it personal, and that's great. Obviously here for the environment, but it's going to have ripple effects because these employees are living it. They're taking it home and doing it there as well.
So Carlos, this is a large solar field. How much of it powers your facility?
It's around 10% of the power of the facility, and it's directly connected to the plant.
I like the tracking device too that maximizes the output of the solar panel. That's great.
Last year, we constructed and put in operation our on-site solar array. It's over 3,500 solar panels, all made in the USA. In celebration of the opening of our solar array, we actually named each of the solar panel stanchions after one of our employees. And what that does is that helps drive employee ownership and also raise awareness.
Eric and Carlos have really done a great job operationalizing sustainability and sharing beauty with all and our global strategy within the factory and personalizing it to this Arkansas community.
Seeing some things that were immediately obvious to the GM team that I've walked past every day was a great learning experience for us. I definitely looked at my equipment and my facility with a little fresher set of eyes this time. I know we can make some quick changes and make some wins for the environment.
So I was originally pretty apprehensive. I didn't expect the kind of manufacturing operations that I see here. And I'm a little more comfortable with it because a lot of the basic principles of energy management I can apply here as well as at an auto manufacturing facility.
I'm excited for the L'Oreal team to come to our facility. I think they're going to be surprised by the scale. We're 4+ million square foot facility and significantly larger, and I'd like to see what they can come up with.
I'm excited to go to GM. Because it's a different industry with different challenges, but at the end of the day, manufacturing is a process, and we're gonna learn a lot from them, but also, I'm expecting to help them to find good opportunities.
Coming up in the next episode.
So it looks like this is where the cars come off the line, and I've been noticing that there's a ton of fluorescent lighting around.
Maybe they don't need all this lighting on, or if they need it, probably they can find a better way just to turn it on when they need it.
So this may be controlled by their energy management system, but if it's a manual operation, it's really hard to know what normal is.